Hello everyone, welcome back to some more Hearts of Iron 4. We are now properly in World War II with Poland being eaten by the Germans. The Poles have set up a fallback line over here, not using the river to its full effect, but then again, they're probably going to get overrun soon, so they won't have the time to. Poor bastards. I did take the time to fix the battle lines in between episodes, like, we now have everyone assigned to the right front lines, etc. Everyone should be hurrying over to the Ethiopian front, squishing out Italy. And then those forces can march towards Italy over here. And go for a successful desert campaign, basically. Which will be good. Japan hasn't joined the Axis yet, they're busy still fighting China. China's actually doing remarkably well. And the French are attempting to attack. Towards Italy itself. Base is in low supply, why is that? No infrastructure. Oh, that's St. Helena. I'm not particularly worried about St. Helena, of all places, if I'm terribly honest. Let's take a look at the air zone here. Enemy bombers active, 1,000. Wow. You guys need to get over here and help fighting. Bloody hell. We are losing a lot of planes with that. Radar efficiency is like 22% now. And we are taking a lot of attrition. We'll do normal operations, there we go. And can we see details? Like, enemy bombing's disrupted. We lost 26 fighters for the cost of 24 bombers. 30 to 36. 36 to 46. So they are definitely losing more bombers than we are losing fighters, which is good. The fall of Warsaw! German forces advancing in Poland have succeeded in capturing Warsaw. Sporadic fighting continues in Prague and a few other districts, but organized resistance in the city seems to have ceased. The Polish government reportedly evacuated the city as the first German units entered Warsaw's suburbs, and their present location is unknown. Fighting against the German invaders continues in other parts of the country, but the loss of the capital is a serious blow to the Polish war effort. We will avenge you, Poland. I promise. Now, did I go to production and remember to... Nope. We're nearly producing a hurricane per day, but I'd rather get a bunch of Spitfires. Spits is what we need. Insufficient resources. Stop importing my bloody oil! Seriously, it's a little annoying. It's gonna hamper our production of destroyers, which is fine. Seriously. Canada, British Raj, get off your high horses. Your high horses? Yeah, your high horses, for crying out loud. Oh, I wanted to go for a... it's fine, we'll build up a little bit more air experience first before we create a variant. Trying to look at air, there we go. Oh, Jesus Christ, we are bleeding dry here. We have lost 100 fighters for the cost of 118 bombers. Which is not bad, admittedly. Like, bombers are a lot harder to build than actual fighters. But this is not good for the RAF. Poland has capitulated. Ignacy Moski has announced that the Polish nation can go no longer without... can no longer withstand the pressure from occupying German forces, committing travesties throughout the country. The Polish government has gone into exile, their main forces have capitulated, and the German Reich is now in control of their home area. Though the war against the German Reich and the rest of the Axis continues, this is an unfortunate setback for all of the Allies. These are dark times indeed. AA hasn't shot down a single bomber yet, even though they have 12 in northern France. How's air defense coming along? We need it a lot faster, I think. Naval dockyards. Get me a... Queen Lizzie. Though, did we ever get the... 2 days. We can wait 2 days. Poor Poland. I wish there was something we could have done. But it was not to be. Dear Lord, we're down to 50%, 25% of our forces here. Total accidents happened, 2. Eh, that's not bad. We lost 200 fighters for 250 bombers. So we're definitely bleeding them dry faster than we are. Well, let's go for the Ark Royal class of carrier. There we go. And free dockyards. Build me... Ooh. Wow, it's now automatically flagged the other ones as outdated, apparently. I mean, that's fair. Greater variant, more reliability. Extra guns. And extra armor. Can't save, it's too expensive. We don't have any naval experience. Blimey. Just build me one then. Yeah, insufficient resources. We're just losing a massive amount of fighters, unfortunately. Production is slowly starting up. Majority type is Hurricane Mark 1. Yeah, we need to stop that for a while, unfortunately. Insufficient resources still. Stop importing my oil, you idiots! Seriously, why... Why should we export to the British Raj, Australia, and Canada? This is clearly something that should be fixed. Let's see, we're currently getting that. We need 3 more because people are idiots. USSR occupies Eastern Poland. Soviet troops have occupied Eastern Poland. Officially for the purpose of protecting Belarusian and Ukrainian minorities from the chaos that followed the collapse of the Polish government. German forces have withdrawn from these areas in good order, resulting in Poland's effective partitioning between the two powers. A likely story. Tension is going through the roof. We have taken 11,000 casualties, Poland has 7,000. It's not going very well. Italy, however, has taken the most of anyone. We're likely going to push them out of the area soon. That would be lovely. Need to select. I don't want to select you right now, I just need it to go back to the theater. There we go. Now, take a quick look at air, because of course we are trying to help France, but it's not working out very well. Someone is throwing fighters over Italy. I think it's France. And I mean, it's... We're just gonna focus on keeping Malta safe for now. Can't really do much for the Yeah, we can't really do much for the French right now. Naval combat's happening. We're sinking more convoys. There's a lot of planes in the air, though. Free civilian factories, great. More factories, simple. We have our air wing over here. I think it might be better to deploy them over here and deploy them in here. There we go. Oh, we lost a destroyer. Bastards. They do have a lot less bombers here, that should help. We'll set it to fly only at 50% strength. There we go. Ideally, we'd be able to start replacing more fighters. We aren't really producing many. Can I, like, check where all my Spitfires are? Where they're going? We have a deficit of 148. We're almost producing as many Spitfires as we are producing Hurricanes, which is good. Because we are not very efficient at building them yet. That's why I kept the Hurricane line in, to get some replacements. Because I knew we would need them at some point. Infantry equipment is still woefully behind. That's a problem of saying, like, hey, we are going to wait with producing things until later on. We shot down 6 bombers, though. And we didn't lose a single hurricane in here. So I think we'll have air superiority over southern France. Which will be great. We've shot down 8 bombers now. Up to 9, but we did lose a hurricane. Yeah, I think we'll keep southern France safe for a while, but it's gonna cost us. Fortunately, however, they won't be able to keep this up for very long. And we do have some French fighters in here to help us out. Yeah, those losses are completely worth it. There we go. HMS Hero damaged 5.2%. Okay. So they are trying to hit us. But then again, we are sinking more convoys. We lost a destroyer. Sunk by a Junkers Ju 87 Stuka. Bastards. So just for my own clarity here. Quickly to the research tech, because I'd like to compare fighter for just a second. Like, you are good at naval targeting, 0.7. Yours is better. Huh. How likely the plan is to hit a ship. Your naval attack is a lot higher. Okay, good. Then the world still makes sense to me. That's fine. Convoy raider battle. We lost another destroyer, for crying out loud. They have 1,000 support planes, 500 fighters, and 44 bombers here. Well, at least we're building our fighters back up a little bit. HMS King George V took a bit of damage there. Quite a bit, actually. But we did sink their convoys. Take a look at the naval, please. Repair priority high. Yeah, okay, good. Just making sure of that. Just making sure of that. Right. I think they've given up on trying to take over southern France for now. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our planes. Deploy them into southern Provence. And we'll deploy them in the Alpine region. Get some air superiority for the French. Make it easier for them to hopefully attack and defend, likely. I'm gonna... Oh, we have gotten some fighting in here. We've lost two fighters to I'm not sure what. We have two destroyers here. I'd rather... Is there an easy way to... What are navies? Not really. I don't see the navies anywhere on the map. We've got our two destroyers in here, then we've got our fleet in here, which is busy. Right click to select all, okay. Can I not just tell you guys to merge? You know what? Head into Malta. There we go. Select everything. Okay. Now we can merge. I'd like a good fleet commander here. We'll get Charles Forbes, he's got AA attack. I like the thought of that. We'll search and destroy over here. We'll avoid the Mediterranean Sea because I don't want to die. There we go. A lot of fighting going on in here. Not really doing anything. Air mode? Yeah, we're not. We lost a fighter here. Accident loss. Oh no. Just deploy to southern France then. And that is what gives us enemy air superiority over here, so that's good. We'll be buffing the French with that. We can modify our government, get a material designer. Or a military staff. Or a theorist. We can get a tiny bit of experience with things. Is there anything actually we can get from this still? No, just the same old. Might not be a bad idea to go for things over here, like air superiority. Extra attack, extra defense, extra agility. Chief of Air Force, minus accidents, plus experience. Chief of Navy, naval speed. Chief of Army. Yeah, I'm tempted to go for air experience gain plus. No, we'll get air superiority expert. There we go. Seeing how we'll be having to do a lot of that in the near future. And you guys are doing decent at this. It's good. I feel like this zooms up. Yeah, there we go. It doesn't zoom quite as much now. We have sunk a bunch of convoys. Huzzah! You guys are set to escort convoys, that's good. We can also go for a search and destroy. Nah, it's fine. We've got some destroyers in here. I will set you to search and destroy. We'll also protect the Norwegian coast. There we go. since it's likely that they will invade Norway at some point. There is some fighting going on the Maginot line over here. Hopefully they'll be able to keep that under control. We've got advanced machine tools, so more production efficiency, which will be all great. We get factory repair speed, seeing how we'll probably get bombed at some point. Although having said that, we haven't lost a... Well, we've lost one hurricane to an accident. Northern France is basically lost, because we just don't have the things. What the bloody hell's taking air defense so long? It feels like forever. We do fortunately have control over southern France still. That's all going okay. How's production of the Spitfire doing? Up to 3.6 per week. Oh hell. German Reich declared war on Luxembourg. German Reich is justifying against us. Oh piss. This is gonna get fun. And they're gonna march into Luxembourg, aren't they? Or we are. Oh, look at that, Spitfires. Or Hurricanes. God, I should be able to tell. It looks like a Spitfire. Those are some Heinkel Ju-88s. Tactical bombers. Interesting. Luxembourg has capitulated. Poor bastards. I feel really bad for them. But there isn't much that we can do about that, unfortunately. We can sure as hell try, though. They've sent more bombers over here, and we've shot them down. So that's good. We still have planes in reserve. Okay. They lost some convoys. Actually, while we're here, get me a new air wing. We're gonna send over all the Whitley tactical bombers. Like, we're gonna use them for something, we might as well use them for this. We've got more enemy bombers in the area. Shoot them down, boys! There we go. Southern France is once again clear. They lost more convoys. Air wing with no mission. Close air support. Yes. Enemy troops bombed. It's starting to go up. Lovely. We're now providing tactical air support to the French. Where it might matter most. Our troops are slowly getting bombed over here. They do have 1,000 bombers still, which is fairly annoying. AA is doing nothing useful to shoot him down, anyway. We're slowly building bombers back up in here, which is good. Air defense finally finished, thank goodness. Let's get rid of all this clutter over here. Now, how's our air defense looking now? 5, 5, 5, 5, lovely. Let's get some more. Make sure that we won't get bombed as easily. Lord knows we are going to need it. Set focus on radar. Thank you. Attacks are happening. They have enemy air superiority, unfortunately. Yeah, there's not much we can do about that. Unfortunately. We're bombing a lot more troops though, that's definitely a good thing. Naval Comet, Central Mediterranean. We found a bunch of a bunch of submarines actually. Hello. Election, wartime exception. The United Kingdom is in a state of war. Normally, an election would be held at this time. But being in the midst of an important conflict, many argue that cannot afford to spend time on political campaigning or a change of leadership if that should come about. Meanwhile, others claim that declaring the ongoing war a valid reason for skipping elections is the first step towards eroding British democracy. After all, letting military matters take precedence over the people's influence could be a slippery slope. We can get some base national unity, which might not be a bad idea. Interestingly enough, those are KV-1 tanks, by the way. You can tell by the shape of the turret. We can also lose it, but gain 20 political power. I think we're fine with holding elections as usual. There we go. And they are starting to retreat now. I think. Do I not get a battle report for that? That's annoying. Oh, well, at least we didn't lose anything, I think. Their bomber losses are starting to go down. Naval combat, just some convoys. Nothing to worry about. I'm more worried about the fact that we're losing the air war quite heavily. Our troops are still being bombed over here, unfortunately. Then again, we are also bombing their troops. Quite heavily. We're building our fighters back up. Can I take a look at you in Provence? There we go, we have to go over there manually. They're getting some Spitfires now. Greater London area. You guys are not. Why'd you lose a fighter? Probably an accident. Yeah. I'd rather be safe than sorry, honestly. How's production going for the Spitfire? Up to 4 per week. We're still very slow at building production efficiency up. Justification still going on against us. Engineer Company 2 is researched. Lovely. ...1939 still, yeah. Let's get the Crusader tank. There we go, we'll keep that on the screen. It's still a stalemate in here. They do have air support, which is helping. But the Blitz is still flying over Paris like nothing's happening. Which is accurate, by the way. Like, the Germans basically had complete air dominance and they could use their Stukas to dive bomb just about any resistance the French would put up. It was a mess. And we're hoping to somehow not get messed up with that. We do have 20 AA guns here, which will help remarkably well. It's a good first step, I suppose. We do have radar level 2 in here, which is very useful. It's gonna help us intercept ships and things. Just things in general, actually. Submarine flotilla. Convoy raiding. The Danish belts. We can try and sneak in there if we want. We'll assign someone who is good in blockade runner? No. We've got Admiral John Cunningham, he's got good skill all around, I suppose. We're actually pushing into Italy now. Oh, they've just got a bunch of forts. Eastern North Sea. Well, let's take a little bit of air. Is there anything here belonging to the Germans? Not really. Greater London area. Give me 100 swordfish. We'll pour you guys into the channel. Why not? Just naval strike. There we go. Battle. Sunk 3 convoys. We just lost another fighter here due to an accident. That's all good. We haven't lost a single bomber yet to any accidents. The tactical bombers are doing their work. Not remarkably well, but still, they're doing okay. Helping to hold the line. What we really need is the AA in here to start shooting some bombers down. Like, AA wasn't great at it, but it certainly wasn't that terrible. Like, they did land hits, eventually. France just needs more AA. Also, I think it might be a good idea to start researching better AA, which will improve our regional AA as well. At least that's what I'm going off of. Not entirely sure if it does, but, you know, there's only one way to properly find out. More naval combat, so that's probably just a single convoy being sunk again. We've nearly got improved decimetric radar to get up to state level 3. I don't have a template for Mudrise still. I want to say that we're working on it, but we're not really working on it. So we do have a bunch of active fighters here, apparently. Somewhere. Must be France. Somewhere. But I don't really see them anywhere. Certainly not one of our aircraft. Yeah, no, and they're gone again. What are we doing over here? We did just lose a bunch of fighters. And they lost a few support. Interesting. They've gone and established air superiority over the Alpine region. So, you know, we're still going nowhere here. Not great. Entire month, yeah, we did lose a few things, but nothing major. Improved decimetric radar! Lovely. We can nearly get the centaur metric radar. And we need... I'm gonna wait with that for now. And get us some other things. This is still a year ahead of time, unfortunately, so is that. Working on construction. I think it might be a good idea to go for anti-air upgrade. It's only gonna take 90 days. There you go, it's gonna be very useful in the coming war. Which is already sort of going on right now. Enemy troop bomb is up very high, though. It's very nice. Got some more naval combat going on in the English Channel. It's just nothing but convoys. For some reason, Italy is sending convoys up north. We can't actually get submarines in here, which is annoying. Although... our relationship is neutral, so we could. Information spread, convoy rating, it's all good. More fights in the English Channel, more convoys. They're pretty much dead. Italy is attacking into France with no any with not any real results. How are the casualties looking? We have lost 22,000 men. Italy has lost 250,000. France has lost 135,000 because of the going back and forth. Germany's only lost 74,000 so far. Ethiopian front is in disarray. Let's take a quick look at that. I would like you to attack over there, if you could. I'd like you guys to go over there. We can encircle them. It's just a question of not wanting to, for some reason. Should help that attack. There we go. A little bit of micro. There's like a million troops over here, so we can't go push over there right now. Why are you failing horribly? Oh, they've got a bunch of troops there. Yeah, no, that explains it. AI, you are doing your job just fine. Get me all the close air support. That's it. Is that technically in our territory? I think it bloody well is. That just removed a fighter wing. That's not what I wanted to do, unfortunately. Eritrea, get me 100 of those. That's fine. 300 hectares. There we go. Just deploy. Go. We're gonna make sure that Ethiopia becomes ours. As it stands, the AI is doing an okay job. Italy has poured in a lot of troops here, but we have contained them, which is already a good thing. Right, these troops here in Halifax, right? Yeah, you're all still moving the link up, that's fine. Although, I can go ahead and... cancel! Because what we just did was select all the other things that we didn't want to get rid of. You guys can deploy over to the Western Front. There we go. Select the entire army. Everyone is assigned to that front line. There we go. We'll have 22 divisions over there. And that should be enough to push into Belgium and hopefully prevent the Germans from flanking into Paris. Oh boy. This might go horribly wrong, I'm not gonna lie. Justification still. I don't wanna press diplomacy, I wanna air war, there we go. How long is it going to take you to deploy? Nearly there. Okay, that's good. Thankfully, we did manage to secure this airfield. Begin air superiority and begin that. There we go. This should help out tremendously. Now we have both air superiority and air support going rampant. We instantly lost a fighter to an accident, unfortunately. There we go. Bombing has commenced. That should help our troops down there make a push. Southern France. Most of Provence is actually gladiators now. It's a bit of a mess. We did finally lose a bomber to an accident. And overall, things aren't going too badly. Could be worse. We do have like 4 hectares. We'll deploy them as well. We might as well. If we can help take out Italy that way, that would be lovely. Close air support, standing by. Just do ground support. There we go. Troops bombed, relatively stable. That's all good. How many fighters do we have here? 940 bombers left. AA is still terrible at taking them out, unfortunately. I imagine that's going to stay for a while. At least we have air superiority over the greater London area. And the channel, etc. Production. Spitfires up to 5, nearly 6 per week. Hurricane still doing a reliable 4 per week. Still bowling up some efficiency on the Spitfire though, so in time it will pay off. I think we found a big fleet. Yes, we did. Hello. They already lost 2 destroyers. Our King George V is doing a lot of damage on them. Lovely. They have a major destroyer clash, but they are about to die. We took out the Cruiser Light as well, I think, or it just fled, I'm not entirely sure. But I believe that that was a major victory for our naval forces there, which is very nice. We do have 108 air experience now, which is fantastic. Very nice indeed. Germany actually pushed through a part of the Maginot Line. Oh dear. Can we provide a counter push here? The answer is no. Oh boy. That is very bad. They're starting to push through. Though this one will be won. It's still not looking too great. What are you doing, Germany? Around the Maginot. I have a bad feeling that that is not going to be good for us. Where's around the Maginot? There it is. Gains war goals on Belgium and Netherlands. Oh, fantastic. At least we're ready for it. Which is going to be our saving grace. And if all else fails, most of those troops will be Canadian anyway. But yeah. Canadians are actually pretty badass. All things good. Japanese diplomats in Berlin. A new partnership is being developed by Tokyo and Berlin. Negotiations have begun for a pact between the two states, citing both strategic interests and shared values. Oh dear. Japan is going to be entering the war soon. Let's get rid of the day-night cycle right now so that we can actually see things a bit more clear now. There's now war against the Netherlands. Oh boy. Is Belgium involved as well? No. But they have gone for the Netherlands for some reason. Which is weird, right? Oh, hello. Send volunteers request from the United States. A single division. Wow. Now Belgium is in. Actually, let's... You guys should have planning bonus from this. Let's delete all the orders. Add a front line over there. And a fallback line. 2. There. Okay. You should all be moving towards the front line now. Yep, there we go. They're moving towards the front line. And if I hit this button, they should start moving towards the fallback line. Oh god. Japan has joined the Axis. We are further pushing into Ethiopia though, which is probably a good thing. That's okay. But this has gone on long enough. I'm gonna end the episode here. So, if you enjoyed the video, then please do leave a like down below. Leave a comment if you have anything to say. And until next time, have a good one, folks.